from the producers of... Critics are calling it sensational. Absolutely terrible.
Hey, who wrote that music? Hello again, I'm Kaz Bielan. I'm here with
Johnny Lombardi, known Gemini.
Why do you have to say such a long name? I don't go Kazimir, Kazimierz Bielan, whatever, Kaz.
Because everybody turned it off right then as soon as that
happened. Don't anybody touch anything.
Okay, go. Today we have an awesome, beautiful interview for your wonderful audience.
And it's our very first guest on Comedy Conversations featuring comedians. He's a comedian. Look, because it says comedian Larry Stevens. Hi, Larry.
Hi. Hey, I got a question for you guys. I saw at the beginning that your reviews were sensational and terrible. So my question is, Kaz, are you sensational? The guy to the left is like the terrible one.
Okay. We should put another show, Good Comedians. We need another show that has good comedians. Larry, I don't know what show you're going to be on right now.
So. You ever seen Shark Tank and they have Mr. Wonderful? Well, now we've got this guy here, Mr. Terrible. There he is right there.
Oh, my God. It's unbelievable.
It's more like this guy and that guy. Okay. And you're the other guy.
Larry, so being a comedian, how did you start, my friend? Tell us how.
Well, I started at this club at 31st and Coastal Highway in Ocean City, Maryland. This crazy, crazy guy named Gemini was running this club.
Him?
And yeah, him, that guy right there.
You never told me about that.
He used to let me come down every weekend and perform at his club. And the first time, it was a year later. Now, I used to go on stage without my glasses because when I first started, I was too nervous to think about the audience looking
Let's
at
check
me.
Check you out. Let's
see. I'm blind without
my
glasses.
Oh, okay, that's better.
Yeah. So a year later, I had friends that came to see me for the first time, and I said, "Hey, Johnny. By the way, I just want you to know I got some friends that are here tonight." And he says, "Well, Larry, I got to tell you, man, you're not going on tonight." I'm like, "Johnny, what do you mean I'm not going on tonight? My friends came down from Baltimore to see me." "Larry, read my lips, puppy. You're not going on tonight." I'm like, "Johnny, what did I do? Did I offend you?" And he says, "No, Larry, look at me. You're not going on tonight if you don't put your effing glasses on." So he was actually the guy that made me finally go on stage with my glasses. And I learned to talk to the audience. And I actually got very good with improv. Right. And also, I remember one time, Johnny, it was a Saturday night. We didn't have a good crowd book. So I dressed up as a clown and I went out to Coastal Highway and I was moonwalking and I was pointing to his sign. I was pointing to his sign. It said comedy show tonight. And I did it for like 4.5 hours. And we ended up with a packed house on a Saturday night. The only problem that I have is I've kind of been obsessed after that to get back into a clown outfit. And I've had some problems with that. I've seen some psychiatrists. But
Larry, hold on.
You didn't tell everybody the Saturday night, all the people that came. There was a clown convention in town. You understand? So let me tell you, everybody blowing a horn every time they thought it was a funny joke was horrible.
But seriously, I did have some problems with where I always wanted to get back into my clown outfit, and I saw a psychiatrist. I couldn't get out of that, but I'm good now. It's been like 15 years now, and I'm all good.
Whoa, what happened there? Whoa, let's go back. That's like what the heck happened there?
What are you talking about? What do you mean, what happened?
Now I recognize you.
Look at you.
Oh, my God. I was wondering who the other guy was.
You know who I am now. Good.
you know, you don't have to wear a mask with that, my friend.
Thank you. Know what
I mean? That's awesome.
I think we should go take the Wayback Machine again and look back at Larry, the way he looked and acted back in the old days. You want to set that up for us, Larry?
Yeah, let's check it out. Which one are we doing? We're doing the, are we doing the Alexa?
The old one. Classic Larry.
All right, let's check out Classic Larry. I love it.
Interesting, Larry.
Oh, hey, you know, what are you guys doing? It's in my contract that you're only supposed to be playing clips of me with the red notes. What the heck, guys?
Hey, screw the contract. You know, we don't believe in those stinking contracts, all right?
Well, we actually have one of the waitresses that worked for you when you finally, and you opened up your own club out in Maryland.
Yeah.
And we have one of the waitresses from that club that wanted to come and say hello, that kind of missed you. You know what I mean?
Oh, hi.
Where is he? He's right there. Yeah, see, there he's on the TV
look,
thing.
Look that way. Oh, that way. Yeah, there you go. Say hi, Larry.
Is that him? Yes. That's him. That's Larry. Yes, that's Larry.
Hi.
You owe me money.
What?
Stop. He touched me. He didn't touch you. Would you just every time he wanted my tips, he didn't want your tips. Stop. He grabbed
tips.
Me.
Tips, money.
Just stop. Oh, okay. You owe me money. Just stop. Okay. All right.
Where'd she go?
I thought it's a very, maybe that's the one that wrote Terrible.
The waitresses always love me at my club.
Yes, they did.
They all did.
But Larry used to always come to the club down in Ocean City, and little by little got a 100 times better. Anytime as a comedian, the best thing to do is to get on stage as much as you can, experience. Don't make the same mistake twice. But he has one of those heart and souls of a true comic when you could just stop and enjoy being on that stage and hearing the laughter. There is nothing, it is the best feeling, the best emotion that you can actually bring out.
Yeah, how do you feel when you're out there? What, express to us, someone who's never done stand-up comedy, you know, go through the quickly process of what it felt like before, the fear maybe, and tell us about it. What is it like?
Yeah, so, yeah, I mean, it's definitely the best feeling in the world, you know, to walk into a room of strangers and have them laughing and have tears coming out of their eyes. And one thing I learned from Gemini, which he was the first one that I really saw do that, and I still see him do it at his shows, is he's very good at waiting, like at the exit and just saying goodbye to everyone or walking around after the show is over. And so I learned that from him, and I do that on all my shows. I stand by the door, and when somebody walks up to me and shakes my hand and says, "Man, Larry, that was great. You were so awesome. I love that. I really needed that." That is the best compliment ever. You know, I just love that.
Hey, we got one more little clip of you just, you know, showing you just a funny moment. God,
we actually got permission for this. You know, it wasn't like the crack staff dug up the other one, you know.
Oh, that's good. I'm glad to hear that, guys.
This one's kind of using the new technology, so we'll appreciate that.
And I really enjoyed talking to you. I really did.
I love chatting with you too, Larry. You're such an intelligent person.
Bull crap. No woman has ever talked to me like that in my life. I couldn't take it anymore. I got into this thing and I worked with it and I changed it around. And now if you hold this button down for 5 seconds, it turns Alexa into real woman mode. See if you can tell the difference. Alexa, turn off all the lights in the house for me, please.
Why can't you turn off the lights yourself? Why do I have to do everything around you? God forbid your ass should get up off that couch.
All right, Alexa, I'll turn the lights off when I get home, okay?
Why do you want all the lights in the house turned off? Are you going somewhere?
I'm going out with Kathy.
And you're going out with Kathy now?
Yes, I'm going out with Kathy now.
I want to know why. What's wrong with me?
Well, nothing's wrong with you, Alexa, but she has a pulse and you're like a freaking hockey puck.
Did you just call me a hockey puck? You are such an asshole. You just don't appreciate what I do around here.
What do you do around here?
I sit here all day on this table waiting for you to come home. And when you finally do come home, it's always Alexa this, Alexa that. Alexa, tell me the weather. Alexa, play a song. Blah, 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 blah.
Larry. That sounds like you were married. Larry, that sounds like a wife. Oh my God. Hey, great little fun bit, bringing out making a little modern there, you know. But I know that you down there in Maryland are constantly trying to bring comedy to the area. Do you have any upcoming things that you'd like to say? Maybe somebody out there is going to want to do one of your shows. And
yeah,
then you bring me.
So what I like to say is, you know, we do fundraisers, any type of fundraisers, and I have the ability to bring Gemini here and myself. We can do a great, great show for you. You can just go to Facebook at facebook.com/comedianLarryStevens. But I would like to add one thing. You know, the first clip you paid, right, Kaz?
Yes.
So that was inspired by Gemini, because the very first time I saw him was the All-American Sports Bar in Glen Burnie, Maryland. And Dave Lovkin booked me in there with him. And I was watching his comedy, and I realized this guy, like, is acting. He's not, like, just telling jokes. He's acting, and he's got facial expressions. And I was like, this is what I want to do. You know, this is what I want. And I wrote that flash card bit that you saw, the first clip that you played in it. And there's a lot of facial expressions in there, and I'm doing a lot of acting, and it's what makes the bit so, you know, do so well. But it was inspired by that man to your left.
Well, Larry, hold on. So funny you say that, you know, it's facial, and he can actually teach other things besides humans to make facial expressions, because we have this show called Studio at the Hill, and I don't know how he did it, but he got a bunch of fruit, like, to actually talk. So check this out. This is-
okay.
What are you doing, Gemini? You gotta stop with all the cookies and the soda. Now go back into the fridge and get the orange juice.
He just wants to come back, this guy. Go ahead.
I get Larry, that's how I taught you.
Yeah. That's how you taught me with the fruit.
You know, Larry, if you noticed, every time I was teaching you something, there was a refrigerator behind you.
Yeah.
I don't know how to tell you.
And then, of course, I used to air check back then. It was just a cassette recorder. And I'm listening to myself, and he would be leaving me all these crappy messages. You know,
still
when I'm
driving
home from Ocean City, you know, I can't even say some of them that you left me.
He would tape his shows, but not visually. He would audio them on a tape recorder. So I'd be sitting in the back of my room watching him perform, people laughing, but I would make little comments that he would hear on his drive back home. You know what I mean? So that's little comments. And they always weren't clean, let me tell you.
No, they usually were not clean. Okay. They were very, very rarely clean.
But they worked. You learned the lesson. All right, Larry. Hey, this was a lot of fun, Kaz.
Wonderful to have Larry on, but I have a question for you, Larry. Final question. What was it like being a guest on Comedy Conversations featuring comedians like yourself?
Oh, man, this was great. I highly recommend this for any other comics out there. I've already seen my Facebook page is already, I've already got like 25 likes from you guys. Have a lot of power, man. It's unbelievable. I'm thinking by the end of this show, I'm going to have like 30 likes.
It's just me doing it 30 times. Hey, Larry, thank you very much for coming on the show. Kazzy, thank you, buddy.
Hey, thank you. Right, thank you.
Thank you, guys. It was awesome. Great time. Thank you.
Come
back anytime.
From the producers of... Critics are calling it sensational, absolutely terrible.
I didn't know what happened there. I thought like somebody hit the camera sideways. Like, oh my God, what's going on?
You know, I was going to bring the puppet that, you know.
See, Kaz, what happened there is it's funnier if I do this.
Yeah.
Then if I do this.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Hey, Larry, thank you very much. We'll send you the clip to put out, and I hope to see you soon, buddy.
Yeah, that was awesome. Thanks, guys.
Super. Bye.
Bye-bye.